All right, so if we take a look here at the clavicle, this right here is actually going to be the sternal end of the clavicle. It articulates with the clavicular notch of the manubrium to form the sternoclavicular joint. Then over here at this end is the acromial end of the clavicle that articulates with the acromion process of the scapula to form the acromial clavicular joint. Now if we take a look here, we kind of flow across this clavicle, we can kind of see that as we're going this way, this forms a convex curve, and then it kind of comes down and forms this concave curve. That convex concave curve helps us to let us know that because of this, this is definitely a left clavicle, because the concave should always be down at the acromial end and the convex should be down here at the sternal end. So we know because of this that this is definitely a left clavicle. Now what we're going to do is we're going to flip this over here, guys. If you look here, this big bump right there, that big bump right there is called the conoid tubercle. It's called the conoid tubercle. And then right here we have the trapezoid ridge right there. Then we have this little groove right here called the subclavian groove. It's where the subclavius muscle attaches. And then if I come down here, there is a small little attachment point here for the costal clavicular ligament. And it might be a little hard to see, but there is an indentation there. All right, guys, that pretty much gives us everything we need to know about the clavicle.